Welcome to the fourth and final short video that shows raters and HVAC installers how to measure the airflow of whole house ventilation systems. In this video, James and I will be showing you how to measure the airflow midstream in the ventilation duct. Two places where this might commonly occur are in a duct that brings outdoor air to the return side of the HVAC system, and in an ERV or HRV system. And the two options for you to use are either an airflow measurement station or an integrated diagnostic tool. So first, let's show you the airflow measurement station. While this sounds pretty fancy, it's actually a really simple device. The first part you'll need is the airflow station itself, which is just a section of hard duct with a test port in it. A smooth surface is needed to reduce air turbulence and make sure that the measurement is accurate. Here we have about an 8-inch long airflow station. The length is twice the diameter of our 4-inch duct. We've checked the distance both upstream and downstream of the station and confirmed that it meets the manufacturer's requirements for an accurate measurement. The second part you'll need is the airflow measurement instrument. And the key feature of this is that it can simultaneously measure and average the airflow across the duct diameter in at least 5 locations. This is really important because it means the rater doesn't have to insert the instrument at different depths and take multiple readings. This is a real time saver, and it provides a much more accurate and consistent measurement. Here you can see that the instrument we're using has 6 measurement locations and that it's designed specifically for this duct diameter. In other words, a 4-inch probe for a 4-inch duct. The third and final piece of equipment you'll need is a manometer, which connects to the airflow measurement instrument. Okay, let's show you how this actually works. You can see James inserting the airflow measurement instrument into the airflow station, making sure that the probe is inserted all the way into the duct and facing in the right direction. Now he's taking the average pressure reading over 10 seconds. Using the airflow measurement instrument, James has measured a velocity pressure of 0.1 inches water column. We can convert the velocity pressure into airflow using the manufacturer's equation, 61 CFM. There you have it. You've measured the airflow midstream in the duct. This approach is probably going to be the most useful for systems where a duct brings outdoor air into the return side of the HVAC system. The second option for measuring the airflow midstream is using an integrated diagnostic tool. This is a tool that's integrated directly into the ventilation equipment that allows a rater to assess airflow. It may be pressure taps, so the rater simply needs to connect a manometer, or the device could even report something like watt draw that can be converted directly to airflow. The key here is that the manufacturer must report an accuracy that's equal to or better than 15% of the measured flow. James measures the average pressure over 10 seconds with that device and gets a reading. So using an integrated diagnostic tool with static pressure taps, for instance, James could simply measure the average pressure over those 10 seconds and convert it into airflow using the manufacturer's conversion table. It doesn't get much easier than this, and my hope is that long-term, every ventilation device will come with a feature like this. Shipping products with integrated diagnostic tools makes it so much easier to compare them that I can't imagine a future where raters use any other approach. In the meantime, you can also use an airflow measurement station as we've just demonstrated. This concludes our 4 videos. Hopefully this helps you better understand how to measure ventilation airflow using ResNet's new standard, a critical step for any home with a ventilation system. From all the team at the ENERGY STAR Certified Homes Program, thanks for watching.